So hey everybody, I stopped in here at Clackacraft today to take care of some business, and I see Jake has got his brand new, or I don't know if it's brand new, but his own personal power drifter. And this thing is awesome. This is the boat that I envisioned years ago when he first, you know, Clackacraft first started making the power drifters. They weren't anything like this. But this boat is just amazing, so I just wanted to show it to you. This is Jake's boat that he put together himself, and I knew it was Jake's boat right away, because Jake would put the huge thumping stereo system in this thing. I mean, that's a heck of a...
Mostly in the showroom, but you know, once in a while on the river.
Yeah, Jake, hot weather days. Yeah, Jake likes his music on the river. And, you know, and Jake's an experienced, you know, good fisherman that does a lot of fishing, but, you know, fishing's not everything to Jake like it is to some people. You know, just going out in the river and having a good time is part of the whole program, and this boat he's built very much to do that.
Multi-use boat.
But there's so many cool things in this boat. So I'm gonna let Jake take you around and show you all the little cool features that that he's put in this boat that I really like. And you know, anybody can do this now, but this has been years in the development.
It's been a long time. My boat kind of gets left behind sometimes, but I finally got up to par, like you said, probably since last time you were just here. It's been coming together.
Yeah.
It's nice to have something to show everybody, because there's so much other people want to do, and there's just a lot of little things you could do. It's probably overkill, a lot of this stuff, but it's nice to show people what you can do and what you can't do. I mean, a lot of things, personally, I guess, if I may not have all this stuff, but I have people ask me about stereo systems and things, and why not have some fun toys and gadgets in it, you know, to have more fun with your boat, you know, because you can, like I said, you can use this for multi-use stuff. I would go up to the lakes with the kids and tow tubes before behind it, which is fun. So, you know, this boat itself has a lot of options on it. And, you know,
so the stereo system, like, what is that? Just if anybody's curious. I mean, because this thing cranks, I've heard it, and it's
a high end GL audio system. It's marine, all marine grade. It's got a 10 inch subwoofer right here with the built in amp in the back. It's got the head unit over on the other side. Over here you can see it produces, you know, enough power to run your side channel speakers. So, and like Justin's saying, it's all JL Audio, this particular one. We use some other brands, Clarion, and there's lots of good brands out there. We're not specific on brands, but this particular one's paired up and matched really well, and it sounds good. There's almost zero distortion at the highest volume. So,
yeah.
You know, it's just a fun gadget. It's not something obviously necessary, but it's, you know, one of the other fun toys you can do, you know, along with the gator step in here, you can see.
Yeah.
You know, we've had these custom match, kind of what a lot of your ski boat companies are doing now. Makes it nice for standing the boat all day, a little softness, setting tools down on this, kind of keeps stuff from sliding around. So we put it throughout this whole boat. It's a kit, you can do partial.
So this flooring here, I mean, so what's the material? I mean,
it's a foam type of material. I couldn't tell you specific on it, but it's really extremely durable.
Yeah.
You know, there's even a guide that just did one on one of his drift boats, and he used it for two seasons, and he said it held up really, really well, even with people lightly using it with studded boots and stuff. So I was surprised to hear that. Along with, bait fishermen with eggs and different things, it actually washes up really well.
That's a big deal. But you can't, if you feel this, it's really soft, so you can stand on this all day, even in bare feet.
Yeah.
It's not going to heat up like other things will. And yeah, I really like this flooring.
It keeps stuff from sliding around your boat too, which is nice. Yeah. You know, it's one of those things not necessary, but it's nicer. Like, even if you're going to go out, like say in the summertime and stuff, and you'll take your shoes off and stand the boat, be comfortable, you know, or like you said, with your boots on, you get a little more spring in it, and makes it much more comfortable and be in the boat. So it's fun.
Yeah, no kidding. So you got nice Garmin system there, but you put whatever.
Yeah, we do Garmin, you know, whatever the customer likes. This is just one I picked up and kind of like. I do Hummingbird stuff too, which is really nice. Lowrance. I mean, everybody builds a pretty nice unit nowadays. So
yeah, it's pretty
find
nice
your favorite thing. Flavor, put them in there, and I hardly use it because type of fishing I do on the steelhead fishing on the Clackamas and local rivers here. Not something necessarily eat for that, but if you go out to Willamette, Columbia, and you want to do some sturgeon fishing or salmon fishing and try to find the fish or kokanee fishing, you know, you may use that. So nice placement for it, because you can see right here we actually have a mount for a trolling motor seat, which I don't have at the moment here to show you, but, and this brace could be removed out of the boat And then you can actually sit back here in a Springfield adjustable seat bracket, and it makes it really nice. You're back here running your tiller motor. You can sit here, you're comfortable. You have plenty of room because this, like I said, this could be removed out of the boat. You can put yourself a nice Yeti cooler over here on that side, a nice spot to, you know, cut bait and do all that stuff right here. It's a really universal boat, really is. So yeah,
that's cool. And then you could do this in a center console too.
We have a center console here, you know, but it's definitely a center console version. It's a little bit more money just because of the details on it and the extra components you need in order for that to work properly with hydraulic steering and stuff. But you know, as far as the boats go locally, I kind of like this deal, but like I said, in the Northwest here where I'm at, but there's a lot of people that really like the center console. And it's been real popular as well. So.
Yeah, well, you know, when I first saw the Magnum, I said, well, hey, build me a center console. Let's see what you did. And I love it, but, you know, I'm from a different part of the world where we do
and they're both great boats. I mean, I could jump in this one or a center console and have a great time in either one of them. Just in the skinnier, shallow water in the summer times and stuff, the tiller just has a little more response for that turning up those channels, you know, being that instant steer.
Yeah, sure.
But, you know, these boats, as I was just saying here, everything's removable throughout the boat, as you can see. These boxes are all fixed to the floor with a 3/8 screw to the floor there. They're all threaded in the floor, so you can put them anywhere if you want. There is some, you know, general spots where you do have the foot brace. A lot of times I won't even have the foot brace in the boat. It's an option to have there. The rower's pedestal box is removable, so if you ever want to go out in the estuary or bay to go do some crabbing or something like that, where you want to have the boat kind of more open, you can take all this stuff out. Have your toy motor seat back here, maybe have some coolers you could sit on, or put the double boxes in the front so you kind of have a basically an open area here to put traps and, you know, your coolers and all your buckets and stuff. So it's kind of fun to have something like that where it's real universal and it's easy to do. It takes seconds to pop that
So this
out.
Is 18 foot,
right? Center line, it's about a little over 17 center line right there. Okay. So, you know, it's overall.
But there's a lot of room, you know, especially if you take those boxes out, it's a roomy boat.
Roomy boat, you know, it gets kind of known to be a small boat, but it's actually got a lot of room in the boat. So, especially once you get up into it, you'll see, I mean, that's what our big thing on this boat is. It's just the simplicity of it and the ease of towing and the ease of yanking it out of your garage on a Saturday and go fish for 2 hours in the afternoon. That's a big difference than having a big giant boat where it's a lot more of a chore.
Oh, you know? Absolutely. I love ones I've had because they fit in my garage for one thing, and they are simple. They're so much easier than a
Well, we've had times fishing together, Justin, where we've, you know, what, four of us in there? Maybe one time five?
Yeah.
But, you know,
I wouldn't recommend that, but four is good.
Yeah, four. I mean, obviously, it's a lot of guys, but if you do have that day when you get out with some of your buddies, you know, or family, you know, you can fit them in there, and it's reasonably comfortable. It's not bad, you know. You might take turns fishing if you're standing up, you know, casting and stuff, but it's, you know, you get up there. A lot of times we're just getting up to spots where we're steelhead fishing where we're going to pile out on the bank anyways. So we'll get up to our spots, jump out, spread out, and when we have some buddies together, and it works really well that way too, you know, just a transportation boat as well to get up through stuff. And
sure. Yeah, I really like the side rails here. You got the padding with the, that's a little measure.
Yeah, we hope to get them up to here, but, you know, it's kind of fun to have the big marks on there too.
Yeah. So. That's pretty neat. Yeah. That's nice. Yeah. Now, you're telling me that you, what, 22 knots or something you were getting out of this boat, which is like 31 miles an hour?
Yeah, somewhere in there, It's,
so that's the Tohatsu, what's the
This
what's
is the new Tohatsu, newer. It's been around for about 6 months now, I think a little longer, but they've been advertising it, but they have the same motor. It used to be a 50. They still make it, and it was a 50-35 at the jet. So whenever you see these jet drives and it says a smaller number on the back here, it's actually it was a 50 powerhead 35 jet, but now they count this one, which is essentially a motor they've beefed up the horsepower with some intake stuff and some fuel programming and different things they've done to it. So it's a 60 powerhead 40 the jet. It's actually, I think, you know, about 50 to 80 pounds lighter than most other motors in its class. It's a beast. It really is. I mean, it can carry the weight well. The big difference with this 60 is when you had, you know, 4 to 5 people or just a lot of weight in the boat, this thing will really carry that weight a lot better. Whereas the other motors in the past would kind of drop off speed and stuff once you got over 3 people in the boat. Whereas this motor right here just has a lot of backbone, being a 4-stroke to it, and it really gets up and goes. And it pulls itself really, really well. So, and especially in shallow water and stuff, it's amazing what this motor can do.
Yeah, well, so it's just, these boats can go in practically no water.
Yeah, and our boat's having that tunnel hole down there. It's incredible because I just took it out.
So the tunnel hole
I see that.
All right, so just real briefly, explain why the tunnel holes.
So a tunnel hole, what you're doing is essentially you're trying to get your motor up a little higher. So a lot of boats that don't have a tunnel hole, that foot on that jet will hang probably, I'd say, 5 inches below the bottom of the boat. Whereas this particular one will actually sit up in there and maybe hang about 2.5 to 3 inches, depending on where you have an adjustment on the boat. I can actually adjust it up a little bit and have this thing almost parallel with the bottom of the boat. It's amazing how well. And the tunnel hole, the way we've designed it, just really channels that water right into that foot of the jet. So it's just very, very little cavitation. I mean, the only reason you're getting it sometimes is because you're so shallow. You know, there's no choice. It's just, you're gonna get a little bit of pop and a little air going there. But our boats run extremely well through that choppy water and stuff, and with less cavitation. And that's what that actual shoe's gonna do for you.
So. That's absolutely true.
Yeah, so, yeah. You know.
Okay.
So, you know, pretty. Go ahead.
Oh, well, no, I was going to say, all right, so he's got an electric motor up here. All right, I'll show you. But, you know, the funny thing is, when I first saw this, seven, 8 years ago?
Pretty much,
probably.
Yeah, 14, 15.
I saw this boat and I was like, man, I want one of these. You got to build me one of these. And I said, I want an electric motor on the front. And Jake practically laughed at me. He didn't understand back then, but now he does, and he's got an awesome one on here. And
yeah.
This is the setup that I want. So yeah, show people your electric motor.
Yeah, now since I've been using these things too, it's amazing how well they work. And I still don't, you know, I understand it more and more why we don't use these more and more in the Northwest. And you're starting to see them now. And they are definitely game changers with these bow mount trolling motors. A lot of times with your rear trolling motor, what it does is you look down for a second to tie something, your boat gets off 6 feet. Well, it takes about 12 feet to correct your boat to bring it back. Whereas this is pulling the front of the boat. So if you get over 6 feet, it's going to pull you right back to that six feet. And this one right here is the iPilot link. So you can link it up to a Hummingbird unit. They're kind of specific to that. Or you can just use the spot lock technique, which is awesome. So you're out there just back trolling or holding the line somewhere. You can actually hit that spot lock and the boat will just sit there for you. And it's amazing. You know, this is the fancier version of it with the automatic deploy. There's two versions. There's a Tarova, which is a manual deploy, and there's the Altera, which is the actual auto deploy. And with the Altera, it's kind of nice because, say, I'm out by myself and I'm out with somebody that's not real keen on knowing exactly how to launch one of these or deploy one of these, I can do it all myself. I can literally go up, turn my key off, and this thing's going in the water and hold me in place like that. I mean, it's amazing. So if you have one of these, you can come in here and auto deploy it. It's pretty slick. So I'm back there on the motor. Somebody with me's already cast in, and this thing's, you know, essentially, you know, you got your adjustment up and down. Depending on where you leave it at. So if you leave it, obviously have the trailer here in a position that works best for the boat, it'll always go back to that position. So you may come up and play with it and figure that out. You know, this time of year with shallow water, I've been, you know, really keeping an eye on it, depending on where I'm fishing at. But, you know, you can put away, do your turn in here. This thing's literally out here. If it's on anchor lock, which you have an anchor lock thing here, so I'm curious, it'll sit this. It stopped because it knows it's in the same position right now. So, but literally this thing will just keep you. And this is the 112 version. So that means it's a 36 volt system. Oh, I'm gonna watch that thing. So let's start hitting the boat there. It must have recognized something moving around in here. But you know, this is the 112, which we put the 80 pound thrust on there too. It's just a difference of power for the most part. I'm playing with the 112. I put the 80 on my boat before, but I really like this 112. The reason I like it more now, because I'm using the lithium batteries now, which are really lightweight.
So the batteries have always been the issues with these things because they're so heavy, right? But now check this thing out.
Yeah.
All right, these got some lithium batteries going on here.
Yep, that's a 36 volt battery pack. It weighs about 41 pounds, I was told. Really lightweight. Before, in the past, they'd use three Group 24 batteries that weighed 53 pounds a piece. So with the charger, I was about 200 pounds. Now I'm down to 41 pounds. So that's a game changer. Really is a game changer.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, this particular, it kind of seems funny. I'm sitting right here right now, but I'm actually building a box that fits better for it up in here. And I'm actually going to design a box for up here too.
Yeah.
So it's kind of stationary out of the way because it is so lightweight. I can actually have it in the bow of the boat.
Yeah. No, that's awesome. Yeah. But having something to put it in.
Yeah.
That's the,
oh yeah. You definitely want something to put it in. Like then, I say, we're playing with it all the time. So.
And then also years ago, when it first came out of these, I said, okay, well, can we change the deck a little bit? maybe lower her down, something I could stand on, and instead of the fly fishing thing here. So you've got an idea for that now.
Yeah, we're working on an idea possibly for that. Maybe a multi-purpose type of a deck that can be removed and go back to a brace or a flat deck, kind of like a flats boat or something. Maybe it's about this high. Maybe it has a pipe style brace on there, casting brace, so that way it's safe as well. So when you're standing up there, you know, another quick thing too on this Minn Kota, let's say there's times you don't want on the boat, it's got a quick release bracket right here. This pulls out right here.
Yeah.
We have a real nice plug the way we've set it up here. Pulls out. I can pop this out, have this thing off, you know, in less than a minute.
Yeah.
So those trips you don't want it on there, it's going to be banging away up there. Or for travel purposes, say you're going to head down to Northern California or something and do some fishing down there, pop it off, put it in the boat. It's a little safer for transportation. It ain't going to hurt the boat and you're just kind of hard on the motor.
Sure.
So yeah. Makes it nice.
You know what else I've noticed is this trailer is just insane. I didn't have a trailer like this on any of my boats, so. Yeah. But look at that, it's got a step on it and it's huge. Is this
an aluminum version of our one. The other one we have too is actually a galvanized steel version. It's extremely nice as well. This happens to be a one I had built for us, aluminum, which looks real beautiful here. Sometimes I kind of toss up the aluminum versus steel galvanized. And the standard one coming to our package is actually a steel galvanized one. I think if you're going to be on the coast and stuff, that may be the way to go. It's just going to be less corrosive. You know, aluminum after time might start discoloring a little bit. But if you keep it clean and nice, we could definitely have this option for you as well. So it's one of those things, you know, it's just options. But they both do have the step, which is really nice. Yeah. I mean, you're jumping up in and out of the boat to grab your tackle, your gear to wash the boat. It's nice to have this. I mean, this really can save a guy's hip or knee jumping out of the boat constantly.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, no,
I don't know why more boat manufacturers haven't done them.
I know. Yeah, I love that trailer.
It really is a big deal. And then, you know, getting in the boat too. You know, your truck's backed up to the ramp. You can actually walk up, step on this, walk back, jump in. I mean, most of the time I have my waders on, but it's nice to have the step on there. I never understood cat walks down the center of the trailer because I don't want to get in front of my buddy on the motor in front of the boat when he's putting it back on the trailer. So this makes it really, really nice. And you know, other features in this boat, this does come with split boxes in the front too. Right now I just had, because it was just two of us fishing today, one in here. You can actually bolt them side by side in the front too. My other box isn't in the boat at the moment. Or you can put a cooler up here too. There's an option for a cooler or a larger box, a single box too.
That's what I did. I had an ice chest there with seats on it.
Yep. You know, and that makes it really nice. So,
absolutely.
You know, front standard anchor systems, these work really simple. It's a simple system. A lot of times I'll actually have the anchor already set out on the side of the boat. I'll toss it out the side, come back, cleat it in if I'm by myself. I don't have to reach over the front of the boat to pull it up. I never leave the anchor hanging out there when I'm traveling up river in, you know, fast, shallow water, because it's very dangerous. But as far as the boat itself, simple system. There's other systems out there. If you say, hey, I want to do a Columbia River anchor system, there's a system that clips into here. You can do that too. So you're not tied to this one setup, but it's kind of how I use it. So it's set up that way, you know.
Yeah.
But,
this is a great
boat. Another nice, cool feature too is with kind of the Clackacraft scheme of things, we always had rod tip protection for your expensive rods.
Oh, yeah.
This particular one's got the built-in rod storage tips. This was another feature added about a year and a half ago. It's really nice because, you know, a lot of these rods are getting more expensive and high-end. It's nice to have a tip protector. They will hold up to like a 13-foot, like a spay rod or something too, or center pin rod. You can add additional brackets in here, and I have added an extra set on that side as well, along with one of the S&C rod racks, which are really popular now. A good friend of ours with the company here builds those, and they're great.
You mean the one back here?
You can keep them organized.
These are a good deal here.
Makes it nice. You got a few rods ready to go, you know, when you get out there. A lot of times I'll have my smaller plug rods and stuff I'm not using as much, just stowed in the side of the boat. So say I wanted to do that type of fishing, I do a lot of personally, you know, steel and jig fishing and stuff. So I always have my favorite rods kind of set up there, and then my stowed rods on the right side there too. So fancy oars in here as well, you know. Got the Sawyer oars here, which are a really nice oar. You know, there's plenty of, all of them build really nice oars pretty much for the most part nowadays. You just kind of got to go with what you like. And I kind of prefer the Sawyers. These are the X-Weave version with the shoal cut blades. They're pretty slick oar. As you can see, we have a pretty big selection of different Sawyer oars here. So you get kind of your choice of what you like. But you know, lots of options on this boat. Lots of options to be added. You know, I've done downriggers for several of our customers now too.
Yeah, and I put downriggers on my boat.
Yeah, and which you'll mount right about here. You typically we'll put a nice plug on the side. They're removable, so when you're not using them, you can pop them out of the boat. So there's options for that as well. You know, pretty much anything you've seen on any other boat, we could do on this boat. Just what your flavor of fishing is and what you kind of like to do. Yeah. We'll add it on there, you know.
You know, and the thing is, I mean, of course, these boats aren't free, but they're still a lot less than the similar size. You know, if you're looking at 18, 20 foot, you know, your basic river boat, you know, this is still a lot less money than those are.
You get a lot for, you know, for the value of what you're getting the boat, you know. It's, you know, something like my boat, maybe it's going to add $4,000 or $5,000 to the extra on top of it. But they come, you know, ready to fish with a nice trailer, step trailer, boat. Pretty much you see everything you see in here besides the stereo system, the gator step, the bow mount, the actual trolling, or excuse me, the GPS sonar depth finder back there. But that stuff is all pre-wired on this boat, so stuff you can add. We'll add it for you if you prefer to pick it up yourself. If you get one, you know, we can put it on, we can order it for you, put it on there. But the boat, like I said, comes ready to go with 60-40 boat, trailer, oars, anchor system, you know, your double seats in the front, rowers box, casting brace, everything ready to go, you know. You know, for around that, you know, 25-ish mark, somewhere in there. So, you know, that's not bad.
That's not bad, you know, for
there's a few things you get nickel-dimed on, like a cover and stuff like that. Yeah. But I really work well with the customers to get them in here. They can come in here and work with me on their final part of their purchase, too, and add some gadgets. I've had a lot of guys come and do that, working for an hour and a half to put some pieces. Well, so it's fun.
I know a lot of people that have bought these boats over the years, and I've never heard anybody say they don't like them. You know? I mean, they're
great. I've seen very many change hands. So
not at all. And you know, for me, it's been like watching a little puppy grow up, and you know, you've made a lot of improvements, a lot of, you know, advancements over the years, and you're getting there. Now, just build me my deck, and I'll be happy.
I don't, you know, he still want me to get his for him too, so I might have to let him borrow mine for a year because they've been so popular. It's tough to get them.
So, if you're interested in a boat, any of the Clackacraft boats, you know, I mean, no, what do you take? I mean, what's the time period?
You know, the Magnum, I could probably get one turned around pretty quickly for customers. You're probably looking at the, you know, 4 to 5 months. If, you know, depending on what you're looking for as far as success. A lot of it's right now is just getting, as a time everybody knows we're in, is just getting, you know, the parts and pieces they may want to add on to the boat. You know, we're able to build the boat and get stuff going, but that's always something right now. If you wanted to get a boat, you could get the boat, then we'd come back and we could work on, we have no problem working on getting accessories and add-ons after the fact too, you know, for you as well.
That's just the reality of these times, getting parts and things and just stuff for my shop is just, it's so hard. It takes so long to get stuff, but hey, well, thanks, Jake. You know, this thing is really cool. You've done a good job. I mean, I am really impressed with this. You can come here to Clackamas, Oregon, Clackacraft, just outside of Portland. Give them a call if you're not in the area, you know,
we do demos too. I'm a firm believer, try before you buy,
Use this boat for a demo, probably.
We do,
So you can come by here and take you to the river. Clackamas River is right here, so it's real simple to take it out there and check it out, and you will like what you see. These things are great.
Very fun boats. Yeah, thank you guys for taking the time to check out my at least new Power Drifter here, the Power Drifter we've been selling for a bit here, and the Magnum is an awesome boat. So, like I said, if you're in the market for a boat, check us out, please.
Right on. I can't wait till I get one. I've had three or four of them, but I don't have one now, and it's kind of a bummer.
Because everybody wants to buy yours, because they're so upset.
Yeah, I brought my boat in for Jay because he wanted it for a demo, and then they sold it. And now I don't have a boat, but pretty soon, hopefully.
We'll get one going again.
Thanks, Jake.
Yep. Thank you.